taking a look at what's next in the workshop. AMT's 1976 Chevy Vega funny car. It's actually kind of a wagon, so let's take a look at everything that's going to be in the box. I know you folks have been waiting for this one to come out for a while and are wondering what's going to be in it and what you can all do with it. We've got literally three trees of clear parts. We'll take a better look at the ones in the other box, but you can see the door and the back glass there. Let's take a look at the one I took out of the bag. It's got little rivet marks in all the glass all the way around and a clear scoop. So you can either paint that or leave it clear to see detail underneath the body of the funny car. We've got some new decals out. Check that stuff. We've got all these pretty different mosaics or whatever you'd call them. We've got the smoke here, Vagabond, Chevy Bowtie, tons of sponsor decals, all kinds of cool stuff on there to customize and use as you want. No less than two entire chrome trees. We've got our wheels, moon tank parts, all kinds of suspension and driveline equipment, axles, differentials, shocks and springs. So you can decide what you want to leave chrome, what you want to paint, or how you want to do it. We've got a grill there. We've got a blower assembly, headlights, and the bumpers that we'll need. Or you can do it without bumpers if you so choose. Nice MH Racemaster slicks on the back end. No name on the other side. Beautiful tires, hollow, easy to put together when you have the rims. And then we've got some solid Goodyear poly glasses for the front. Nice tread pattern and name recognition on the side. Let's get out the rest of the styrene. There's not a massive amount of plain styrene in the kit. That's what you're looking at right there. We've got the bottom of the funny car body. You can see the hinges where it will flip up. You can see where the engine's going to poke through. I think where the engine's going to poke through. Beautiful Vega wagon body. Nice detail on there. All the way around. No big flash, no detail missing. No mistakes, looks great. Even got the ribs for the roof on there. Got the nice cutout. And looks great. Also, we've got some body panels, lower air dams, body pieces on there. You can either paint those separately, you can put them on, you can leave them off. It's really your choice with a funny car build like this. We've got our V8 here. Heads are separate. Oil pan. We've got eight individual header pipes, which can be glued in all by themselves, which means you can also paint these all by themselves. You could even paint a couple of an off color to look like you had to replace a couple that might have got bent or blew through. We're all set there. We've got the tops of our headers there. And then we've got a silver tree. Molded in silver, could be left just as is if you wished. Very nice idea for that. Cuts down on some painting or detail time. Looks awesome. Got a detail on our driver's bucket, parachute, frame rails. So what I'll do now is rinse all the parts in simple green just to get any mold release off of them so that the paint will stick later. And I will start with the subassembly show off in a moment. Back on the build table, the subassemblies don't take too long, but they are fiddly, and I'm going to show you that. Now, what we're going to be doing is getting paint on a lot of stuff. I've got the wheels and tires assembled because they are a very nice chrome. They are molded open, and they look lovely. There is no reason for me to mess with those. So those were just pressed together. The rear wheels had their hubs glued in. I like that silver plastic for those hubs. So that will be left alone as well. And those are molded open too with those great Racemasters. Everything about that can be left exactly as it is because they look awesome and will look awesome on the car. The moon tank was assembled with a little bit of super glue left with the factory kit chrome. And that looks lovely. That will look great on the rear end there. The air dams, you can decide to paint those and install them or leave them off. And the spoiler, also the headlight covers, you can either put in the chrome headlights or these headlight covers. I think because it's a funny car, I'm definitely going to use the headlight covers. It wouldn't have operational lights on it. It could be a show car where they light it up as they run it down the track. But anyways, that's all up to you. I'm going to be painting these in my body color of choice, and then I'll decide later whether I want to attach those underneath the bumper or not. You don't have to. It's a funny car. Go your own way. The fuel pump, I want to metallicize, and that will be used on its own tree to get painted. The headers are all done. Those will be attached once we're done assembling the engine into the chassis. And you can see those go together nicely. I want to be painting those up separately, so I left them a little bit on their sprue so we can work on those separately. The belt and pulley system, obviously I didn't want to attach so I could get that painted up differently. The blower I did assemble completely. Now it does look nice in kit chrome, but I'm going to be spraying it and re-metallicizing it with something else in a little bit here. So I did leave that separate from the engine. The steering wheel seat and parachute are going to be very simple. So I did detach those from the silver trees. We'll get those painted up and detailed as needed. All these parts I left on the silver tree, the wheelie bars, the prop rods for the body and the front steering rod. Those are all going to get chromed out with my own chrome paint that I like that we'll see in the paint area. So I left those on the same trees. On the chrome tree, we've got our headlights. If you wanted to use the chrome headlights, which I still may use, and just because they're decorative, so I may push those in. I will be black washing the valve covers, but otherwise leaving them alone. They are really nice. Looks like Mickey Thompson valve covers, so we're going to leave those alone. And the bumper as well. The grill in this kit is not used. It's just on the tree. The V8 assembles quickly and easily without issue, without any problems. This is what will mount it to the frame, to the chassis. We've got our starter oil filter. Of course, you could always leave those off and attach them separately. Our cylinder heads, our intake, and our magneto. I'm going to give this a nice color coat and then hand paint the small details because I just simply enjoy doing that. And then we'll get that mounted in the chassis. The body is all set to go, needs no work. I'm just going to do a little couple swipes with a knife to clean off where it came out of the mold before we paint it, and then we are all set with that. On the frame here, it is quite fiddly, and if you're going to do what I'm going to do and paint the frame, you're all set. If you're going to use the chrome as it is out of the kit, get the super glue out, get your little knife, scrape it, and your model glue, and be very, very careful. But I've attached the inner part of the funny car body to see how it goes on the back. I've also installed the roll cage and the driver's area so I can see how that's going to fit together when we all get it all glued up and permanently located. The inside looks lovely. We're going to be painting this up. That's where our steering wheel attaches. Our steering link goes from here to the front of the car that I showed you. The roll cage is all together, and I can still get the seat in there from the top. It'll drop right down and in and glue into place. Same with the gas pedal, the clutch pedal, which mounts here. We'll all be able to do that and leave those in the chrome so they look kind of neat underneath there. Since this thing has such a large amount of glass, the frame and drivetrain are assembled. Now, I went heavy with the super glue on a lot of parts because I'm going to be repainting it anyways, so it didn't matter to me, but you can see lots of very small parts, radius rods and everything for the suspension is all separate and all in little pieces of chrome, and our little brake rotors and calipers fit on the back axles with the rear wheels. So that's how it's going to look when it's all assembled. I'm going to be detaching the body here, the inner part of the body. I'm going to be painting this a separate color than I paint the body, and then these two parts will go together, and you line them right up to those pins there. When you line them up to the pins and you have the rear attached to the frame, to the chassis, that will center your wheels perfectly in the wheel wells. I've already tested that fit, so we know that works out well. And then you're left with this, which we can hang on the bench and get spray painted and get it all decorated up. I want to do the whole thing in a one color scheme on this one of my own paint color, so it looks nice on there. It wobbles right now because the pumpkin and the rear suspension stick down, but we'll get that all set up, ready to go, and we'll go over and get some stuff painted. Being a funny car, I knew that the Vega would move along nice and quickly because the parts count isn't extremely high. You could see the nice paint effects of that Krylon bright aluminum. That just looks stupendous when it shines on the light like that. Cross-referenced with the chrome of the Rust-Oleum Bright Coat Chrome. We're going to have a beautiful contrast on the chassis, and that is an excellent paint. As you see, I've done the calipers in a bright red since they can be seen, and I do have a little plan to display this in a certain way, and I definitely want to be able to see those calipers back there, so I did use some nice tester's red enamel. The actual roll cage and interior is all set. What I need to do at this point is the stuff that I put some black wash on. We've got the interior. I did the seat belts and the clips with metallic gel pens from Hobby Lobby. Did the little buttons on the parachute the exact same way. We've got our engine mount and transmission painted. Now I just have to go in and detail the magneto, the starter, and the oil filter on that block. Then I can put my blower on there, and I can also put my blower belts on there, put the headers on, put the fuel pump on the front like they want you to, and then mount that inside that beautiful chrome chassis there, which is all done up, looks excellent on the show. We've got the fire extinguisher, wheelie bars, and braces all done in their metallic, very minimal detailing, painted the wheels black, left the center silver, did a black nozzle. A lot of the fire extinguishers back in the day were just a bright chrome or metallic look, so I left that one instead of always painting them red. You can check out the valve covers, look great. The Mickey Thompson valve covers, which work well with the MH Racemaster tires and everything, that vintage parts look on the 76. We've got our headlights done. What I decided to do, instead of using the complete blackouts, the reason I heavily blackwash these, I actually did it twice off camera, is so that I want these to look like they're screened, like they're screen vents in the front of the body. So what I did to complement that is we painted our grill in. I did silver vents on the back of the body because it's a wagon body, and then used the Tamiya panel line wash in there, so it looks like they've got vents and vents in the back to let the air out of the body, so when he goes down the track it kind of clears itself out so that he doesn't get this big cloud built up underneath of air and blow the back window out of the dragster every single time he goes down the track. At least that's my backstory to it and why I did it that way. I've got all the glass being treated with future floor polish right now. Takes about an hour to dry, and when it does, you can see it's mostly dry right now. You can see that it really shines that glass up, and I am leaving the scoop clear. I do want to see down inside there, again, for the idea I have, so I'm leaving it that way. We're going to get all this together. I've got the steering wheel chromed out in the center, so that's ready to go. We're going to be able to put all of our steering wheel, our seat, our controls, our foot pedal, our fire extinguisher in the roll cage, mount that into the chassis, get our nice engine bolted in there, have that all sitting in there looking really cool, get that all together. Then I'll be able to put the glass on the body. After I put the glass on the body, you can see that all the glass has raised rivets. I will be using, because I don't want to do it beforehand because I don't want to rub them off, I'll be using a silver gel pen. Kaiser is just the set that I bought from Hobby Lobby, and I will be detailing every single one of those rivets by hand, just putting a little dot on each one once the car is pretty much done, just before I decal it. I also outline the hood just so that it stands out just a little bit, even though it's not operational. I used a Gundam marker for that one. So, and I'd also, you can also use Molotow black liners. They, Molotow pens take just a hair longer to dry, and I wanted to move quick on this today, so I did use the Gundam marker. The Gundam marker doesn't leave nearly as dark of a line. The Molotows shed ink much nicer into those grooves, so if you had, you know, a little bit longer to let it dry, you could do that. As you can see, I went with a completely different green on the body. When I was doing the trim, you saw that on there. So I will name the green on camera right now. It should be a Rust-Oleum 2X spring green, but if it's not, I'll put the name on the camera right on the screen somewhere here. Otherwise, it should be Rust-Oleum 2X spring green, and that's a beautiful, that's gloss right out of the box, sprayed on and left alone, haven't clear coated it yet at all. It's looking good. easy, super easy build so far, especially the way I want to demonstrate it when we're all done. I'm going to keep working. When I have the engine and the roll cage and everything mounted with the seat and the steering wheel and all that, and get the glass in the body, we'll come back for a peep. When you start getting things together, you realize how cool this kit is. Of course, it looks great. We've got all the glass in. We've got the grill done, the headlights on, the lower pan, the bumper, the spoiler. We're all set. We got our taillights done. We got our parachute on and our rear bumper. So all I have to do on the body after it's been attached to this interior piece here is do those little rivets on there the best I can with some silver and have them stand out, and then put our decals on, and we are all set to go with that. Got our wheels and tires all done. Those look great. Only things left to actually really attach are the headers. We got the props for the body, which don't get attached. We got this little steering arm, which installs on the side here and goes to the front steering. And our wheelie bars, which have pins in them that go on the rear axle and line those up on the back end. We've got the interior all done. We've got the chassis all done. We've got the engine all done. We're just kind of bringing it forward here. I did put this on so you could see how it lifts up and goes down. You see I've got that clear scoop on there. That looks really cool. The engine's just going to stick out of it like so. We can put that all the way back. We've got our fuel tank on the back. We've got our engine in. Our interior is all set and done. I glued in all the little parts, the trans brake, the gas pedal, the clutch, steering wheel, the shifter, and got the seat in there with its belts all done. So that is a cool looking little outfit there. And that just goes right on the channels of the frame on either side. That just goes right down. And I left the bottom that nice raw silver plastic, looks good. We've got the engine in place and all glued together. Ain't she sweet with that chrome chassis? That's pretty cool looking. All the way around, got a blower on there, got the Mickey Thompson valve covers, got our pumps and everything all individually painted, and looks really sweet on that ride. So this is going to fold forward. We've got our little brakes done up back there. We're going to have to remove this and attach it to the body. Actually, I'll probably glue it in place when it's in place, then I'll move it. We're going to be gluing this on here, our steering mechanism. Once that's all on, I will push on the wheels and tires, and then we will attach our decals, and I will be done once I get the little rivets all the way around. When I come back, we'll have that final. Here we go, the beautiful 76 Vega funny car, all done. And we're going to take some pictures at the end so you can see the different way I wanted to set it up, but it's all ready to go the way it is. It's got those cool disc brakes behind the wheels. We got our parachute, our funny car body where I did all those rivets with the silver pin like I was talking about. We got that cool clear scoop that you of course could paint over on yours, but I wanted to be able to see down there. And with the coat of future on the car, on the glass, on that scoop, makes it all crystal clear and super shiny. I like the giant headers coming out. You can see the stickers that I put on, the decals, the decals that they have on the sheet. Now, if you didn't like any of those, they do have quite a few other ones on there. Remember that sheet we showed in the beginning? We still have all those cool flowery decals on there and all the sponsor decals. You can go crazy, put the Vagabond nameplate on. One thing I discovered, if you want to display it with the body up a lot, it is harder to get the wheelie bars to stay on, but they will press into the axle through that little pin there. You can stick them on there that way. Don't forget your two prop rods that you have all set. So if you want to display it down like this, the wheelie bars will fit on nicely. The rear bumper tends to pinch on those wheelie bars when you lift the body up high enough to get this post on it. So you might want to just cut down that post and not display it as high if you want the wheelie bars on there. It is an awesome looking kit. The addition of those MH Race Masters just really sells the whole deal. Highly detailed as far as an older kit goes. Lots of detail on there. You can work it over. You can make it look awesome. You can put the spoiler on, leave it off. I like it on there now that I decided to glue it on there. It just looks cool. And everything looks great on there, and it all fits. That's the nice part. Usually building a multi-part chassis like that, you end up with a lot of fit problems. But this one went together well, as you saw. And then I used a whole bunch of metallic paints to put it together and make it look cool. So I want to thank Round 2 for this review copy. This is out right now. There will be links in the description down there. Pay attention to where you can pick this kit up in stock right now as you see it here. This is built box stock, aside from the paint. That's how I do 99.9% of my reviews. So you can see what can be done with the kit as it comes out of the package and no aftermarket needed whatsoever. Thanks for watching the workshop. Always build for you. Have fun with your modeling is the most important part, and we will see you at the next review.